This is about teaching people the importance of going back to first principles thinking. So what the professor did was she told her students, much like yourselves, that you're going to get $20 of seed money and you will get 2 hours of time. And in the 2 hours of time, using that $20 of seed money, you have to create as much of money as possible. I mean, you have to have a business idea that will create as much of money as possible. And then you will get 10 minutes to go and present this business idea in front of the entire alumni of the Stanford Business School. Now, as you might imagine, many people would immediately start thinking in terms of, okay, so what can we buy with $20? We'll buy lemons, we'll make lemonades, we'll buy eggs, we'll make omelets, and the Indian version of that, this $20 becomes 2,000 rupees. So there's samosa, we'll make samosa, we'll make momo. I mean, there's only so much that you can do in 2 hours of time. But a small minority of the students realizes that this $20 is actually a red herring. It's something that is taking away your attention and limiting your thinking, because you could actually use those 2 hours and make reservations in very popular restaurants and auction those reservations as and when the date came along. And there you are not limited by any seed money. There is no limitation of the money. It's only a limitation of the 2 hours. But the really bright and out-of-the-box thinking students amongst the group realize that they actually have three resources, not two. They have these $20, they have 2 hours of time, and they also have 10 minutes in front of the Stanford student's body. And that 10 minutes in front of the entire student body of Stanford was worth much, much more than several thousand dollars for companies who wanted to come and make a pitch to Stanford students. And therefore, those students sold that 10-minute slot, thereby making the most amount of money. Now, the point that that professor was trying to illustrate, and the reason why I've taken this example, is that during paradigm shifts, it's a good idea to go back into first principles thinking and actually to take a relook and say, this product or this idea that I'm taking to the market, is it relevant in today's world or was it relevant in yesterday's world? Am I just trying to take what was relevant in the world before and superimpose it here, thinking that it'll be of great value?